Ah, the holiday feeling that starts in the air. Then you emerge from the clouds to a place where your time is your own, where you have the freedom to be happy-go-lucky or pamper yourself in the lap of luxury, where you can dive into adventure, nourish your body and feed your soul. A place where you can plan every step or take it as it comes. This is your Samoan holiday, and it's always gonna be beautiful. Beautiful Samoa.
Volleyball starts this afternoon, and it is Guam taking on the Solomon Islands, and it will be Guam to serve first set. The best of five. Solomon Islands on the right as the set is there. Now the spike comes in, but it's wide. You can see there the lovely high elevation they get. The block comes in, and it's terrific work coming in from Teriba. Beautiful positioning of the hands there. Guam looking to take out the first set. It's still on. The rally's still alive. It's gone across, and there the libero. And that is the first set. Guam have taken it out 25-18. They push it wide. The captain can't do anything but just put it into play. On the court of Guam, the nice short set, and there's the block coming in from Hamilton. Kasi did well, the big man at the net there. Eric Ada has the ball. Timed it just before the 8 seconds, and he really sent that with a lot of dominance. Here's the third. McDonald, not eating all he can do. But just get it over. Matthew pushes it out wide. A nice spike again over the block on this occasion. Here come the Solomon Islands. And now set point for Guam after taking out the first 25-18. A very similar score here in the second set. 19 points for the Solomon Islands. Guam looking to take it out two sets, and they'll do just that. Nice spike from Aiden Ferrara, getting up and battering it into. Still plenty of time left, and that's a nice way to start set number three with a lovely winner. They reach high, and they all stood around and looked at each other. The placement from Hamilton Kasi, stunning. And that will give the Solomon Islands the third set. We're heading to a fourth set, ladies and gentlemen. Rama's coming through to spike it like that. A nice big spike. Good dig from Santos to keep it alive. It's back on the side of the Solomon Islands. Matthew puts it up, and in with the smash again is Vapoi. Big serve, nice dig. Put it there. He had to really extend, but they've kept this ball in the rally alive. Have Guam again. It's set now, the cross court spike. Now McDonald. McDonald with the don't answer. Rio Legio. McDonald with that spike, but they're able to dig it out. They go back to McDonald again, second time lucky, yes. Changed hands as well. The first spike was with the right. Second time, hit it with the left, took a little bit of pace off it. There's the left hand. Great point. It's McDonald again. It's the Libero that keeps it alive. Bakaua. Solomon Islands keep the point going. It's there at the net. McDonald this time changes the point of attack and finds a little bit of real estate. Now let's see if they go to McDonald again. This time they go across and nothing he can do but just a left-handed tip. This time the spike from the right-hand side from the captain, but it's blocked by Hamilton Cussey to take out the set and the match. Oh yes, they've done it. Guam win their first game here at the Pacific Games of 2019. They took out the first at 25-18, 25-19 in the second. They lost 25-18 in the third, but they've taken the fourth. And there are the smiles from their coach. Their first win in Samoa. 25-22 in the fourth. Tremendous game of volleyball here, high quality of the 2019 Pacific Games here in beautiful Samoa. So we're all set in readiness. PNG in their traditional red, gold and black, and the white and red, a little bit of blue there for the American Samoa. Straight away, coming into the action is Whangaima from America Samoa. Big serve. That's what he produces with a serve. And the spike is the winner, Junior Jima. Plenty of open court on that left-hand side of American Samoa. PNG looking to close out the first set. They go wide, and nice block coming in from their captain. He had to take the full force of the spike, and now no mistakes from American Samoa. They can't afford to do that. They have gifted the first set to PNG. Too easy. PNG take out the first set, 25-19. Here he is, Whangaima. Bronze medalist last week at the beach volleyball. And the quick play again. Plus one for PNG. Quick set and spike. Job done. Look at that. He's already up in the air before the ball is even placed there. Very nervous, Afu Aosi. Here is Whangaima. They set the dummy and then the spike. Momo Tayara. Have a look at this. It's just beautiful to watch. There's the dummy one. The blocks are there. And look at that, not a block within sight. Rova made no mistake of where he was placing that. Chance here. The dummy. And then the execution at the end there, and it was Pelini Whangaima. Seven all. PNG had thought that they'd won the point. Giacarpa goes over again to have more of a conversation. And he's really asking some questions in there. The yellow card showing. How much belief is there in the men in the white shirts from American Samoa? They need to win this set to send it to a fourth. No chance. There is the reaction from the coach. The shotgun reaction. And the quick play again proves to be the winner for Papua New Guinea. Set up beautifully. And Tua Man is there to slam it home with the spike. Papua New Guinea outclassing American Samoa on this occasion. Vatia Taura'a with the serve. Left-handed bullet. It just makes its way over for an ace. He'll want to try and serve this out if he can. Taura'a. Too long. Too much bicep curls. Too much weights, not enough speed. There he is. Look at him. He is pumped as Olivia Tautu. Might get a double gun after the spike here. About to serve, there he is. He's in the front court there. There he is, look at him. Double guns, showing off his biceps. I would have aimed straight for him. Well, as his teammate, oh my gosh, he is having some fun out here. There's the Tahitian player. Tahiti. 1 point away from taking out the set, and they will take it in straight sets. Tahiti take the third, 25-20. After winning the two in great fashion, the first set, the best of them all, 25-23. And then they won it in 17-20 to take a clean sweep. Tahiti over Tuvalu, and Tahiti remain unbeaten in the Pacific Games of 2019.
Just like the Olympics and Commonwealth Games, shooting has long been a popular inclusion at the Pacific Games. 2019 in Samoa sees the sixth Pacific Games outing for the sport. Teams and individual medal events are being contested by 8 countries across 5 days at the world-class Tafaingata shooting range. Down the Line, or DTL, is a popular variation of clay pigeon shooting and forms a significant part of the competition of the Pacific Games. There are 5 gender-neutral events in the Pacific Games tournament.
Tahiti and New Caledonia. Inbound now. Belleville. Closely marked by Jackie of Tahiti. Belleville kicks it back out. Rodriguez will try another three. This time he connects. They extend their lead. points now the difference. 44-31. Belleville. 5 second shot clock. Misses a tough jumper there. Jackie up the court. Scott there setting a screen for Jackie. Raimoana slips up and gets free. Scott now looking for Summers. Scott drains the three. New Caledonia. Aho to his brother, looking to Ben Yella. The steal, Tahiti. Jackie down the court quickly, should finish. Doesn't go, Scott's dead. Ladies and gentlemen, we've got a ball game on our hands. Hariri Marau with 12 points. Scott with 15 points. Here's Summers. Hariri, 3 points. Yes! He drains that. Tahiti extend 5-point lead. 7 minutes remaining. Weber. Here's Paul. Looking for a screen, doesn't get it. Here's Belleville. He'll try a three. Off the bank. 48-50. New Caledonia. Down by two. Here's Summers, a handoff to Hariri. Hariri around the corner, looking for Scott. Scott's got it, should finish, yes. And right now, Tahiti in front. 5 minutes, 30 remaining. Raimoana to Summers. Summers handoff. Hariri gets to the ring. Fouled Rodriguez. New Caledonia just does not look like the same team that's been playing for the last three quarters, or two and a half quarters, I should say. Hariri makes them pay. Tahiti, big winners over New Caledonia, 65-55.
Here's Salem. Salem back out to O'Shan. Oh, good pass down to Alizé. Alizé is fouled there by Cherish. She was beat on the off-ball screen. Alizé able to find some space under the hoop. And Alizé puts it in. It's an 8-point game. Oriana Rose out to Cherish. Cherish, oh, she puts up the stutter and O'Shan lost her footing. She couldn't catch up and Cherish finishes with a floater. Alizé. A minute left in the first quarter. Alizé's got it. And they go to Salem, who couldn't finish the floater. Inside the Teimana, Alizé. Long three, bang! A much needed three for Tahiti as they close out the first quarter. And so we kick off the second half of Samoa versus Tahiti, the knockout stage round for the women's division of Pacific Island Basketballs. Tepu tries to put up another three, it doesn't go there. Malama Leopipi the other way. They go to Hedick, now back to Malama. Hicks inside, wants it down on the post. They'll give it to Summer. Malama coming around. Kalista to Malama. Three ball from Malama. Bang! So straight out of halftime, Malama is able to capitalize on the energy and puts in a three. O'Shan inside. Gets it stolen by Kalista. Kalista the other way. Weaving through defenders. Malama to her right, back out to Malama. Another three from Malama. And she knocks that one in as well. Two straight threes for Malama Leo Pepe. Alizé LaFranc. And posting down Sommer there. Goes out to Warden. Warden to Tepu. Tepu puts in the three. I'm sorry, that was Salen. So two of the shortest players in the game for Tahiti. Both scoring. And Samoa answer right back. Samoa up by 14. They inbounded. They've got it with Kalista. Kalista getting trapped there. Tavanaya putting on pesky defense. Takes it away. And she puts it in. So a 12-point lead for Samoa. And Summers able to take it to the other side. Tavanaya there to Hassler. Inside to Hicks. Outside to Juanita again. High floater off the bank. And that must be the dagger to end it. And a valiant effort from Tahiti to try and rally to score. But Samoa just too good. Too strong off the board and able to finish their plays.
This to take it out to a 4-point lead with 1 minute 14. Destiny, here's the first one. Yes. First one's good. Now the second. Doesn't get the second one. Hit out by Jasmine. Guam 64-61. 1 minute and 11 remaining. Joycelyn hit away there by Lewis. One ball. We've got 70 seconds remaining. You win, go for a medal contention. You play against Fiji, you lose. We're in fifth and sixth placing against Tahiti. Who wants it more? Guam have the edge. Joycelyn around the corner. Three, two is good by Brianna. Who would have thought? We're looking at the big girls, the big guns. And a three by Lewis. She's done it again, Kazia Lewis. Maria, they don't foul. Destiny. Destiny with it. 66-64. Destiny. And they call a charge on Destiny. Inbound, Main. Lewis looks inside, back out to Main. Is Main still with it? Lewis, big three, can't go. Rebound, Main, still there. Davis, two, can't go. Rebound, Sadler, taken away by Destiny, and they're gonna foul her. I don't think Asia Pepe even touched the ball in that sequence. Well, Destiny can put it away here. She shoots two. It's a 4-point lead. Here's the first one. Misses the first. She's she's upset with herself. She should make the second, yes. Cook Islands call a timeout. 3 points separation. 9 seconds is an eternity in basketball. No need to rush the shot when you get it. Quick two is good. Another quick foul. They got a foul. Yes, they do. Joycelyn can't make it. Cook Islands don't want to line up. Well, she's missed the first one. Cook Islands standing off here. Well, this is very unusual by the Cook Islands. Anyway, here's her second one. She misses.
Are available to them, at least those that are fit. A couple of big outs on the Papua New Guinea side in David Brown and Captain David Mutu. And also Tommy Semi, the speedy winger. He, I believe, is possibly trialling for Wellington Phoenix, the A-League club in New Zealand. That's the word that's being passed around. Now, what's the referee going to make of this? He's chosen to award a penalty kick, so here is a golden opportunity for New Zealand. Warrison and Rogerson went into challenge for that ball. Ball coming in from the left-hand side.
Did you see? Did you see what happened? Was it head on head?
Warrison goes for the ball as it was perfectly entitled to do, and runs into Rogerson. We could have a very groggy goalkeeper up against a very groggy New Zealand captain involved in this penalty. Finally, the referee completes his mission to wave his yellow card, so he'll be happy. Joy of joys, possibly. We could have Ollie White scoring for the Ollie Whites. Or there would be Ollie Whites, really. These young guys wanting to push their way into the Olympic squad for the Olympic qualifying tournament coming up in Fiji later in the year. Ollie White, who plays his club football in Portugal, in fact, the Rio Ave team, up against Warrison. Jiggly little old run there, but it worked for him. Tucked the ball away in the corner, so New Zealand have the advantage. After 33 minutes, they take the lead through a penalty kick. Scored by Ollie White. A lot of frustration, I think, within the PNG ranks, but they've just got to put that behind them. They have more than enough time to rescue this situation, and they have the talent to do it as well. Muscled them out there. Well controlled by the Akers, the substitute, out on the left-hand side. Not the easiest of balls to bring under control, but he did it. Opportunity here, maybe, for New Zealand. There is a player in the middle. Maybe he won't need him. Now, here's a chance for Schnell to settle it. That's an absolute disaster for Papua New Guinea. That's a goal from nothing, really, for New Zealand. First chance of note they've created in the entire competition. I beg your pardon, let's not overstate the case. Entire game. And New Zealand are 2-0 to the good. Afraid Papua New Guinea just caught on the back foot there. But New Zealand so far have a clean disciplinary record in this game, and they have a couple of goals. And well set to play off for the gold medal here at the Pacific Games. And that challenge didn't go down well. And I think this means Komolong is leaving the field. Alwyn Komolong was already on a yellow card, and now he's picked up a second one, and it's all gone very badly wrong for Papua New Guinea. Alwyn Komolong is dismissed for that challenge. And I think there you can see why. It was a pretty wild challenge. I don't think Komolong can have too many complaints. He knew he was on a yellow card. So really, it's been a disastrous couple of minutes for Papua New Guinea. It's all over. And Papua New Guinea will not be competing for the gold medal here at the Pacific Games. approaching the half-hour mark, and still we await the first goal in this Pacific Games football encounter between the last-time gold medalist, New Caledonia, and the side they beat, therefore relegated to the silver position, Tahiti. Arch rivals over many years. The two major French territories in the Pacific. Now here's a chance for New Caledonia, and it's they who take the lead. Bertrand Kai involved, as he inevitably had to be, and finally somebody creates something, and New Caledonia are ahead at the half-hour mark. And that's not good news for Fiji, but some encouragement for Solomon Islands, perhaps, to think that if the result were to stay like this, admitting that there is a long way to go, that Solomons could yet make the bronze medal position. But if New Caledonia hang on to this, then they will be through to the gold medal match to take on New Zealand. There's Bertrand Kai with a little touch, and diverted into the net by the big number 19, Nathaniel Himane. Now here's Tahao, and he is a player who can do a lot better with an opportunity like that, but unfortunately the all-time leading goal scorer for Tahiti, their captain, never really got on top of that shot. Sat up nicely for him, I thought, but just squirted away wide and out of harm's way. Possible chance here. Now, is that going to be a penalty kick? New Caledonia saying no. Well, it looked like Tahiti had a pretty good case. Interesting to see that again on replay. Rocky doesn't seem terribly phased. Well, he took his feet, didn't he? I'm sorry, but I'm slightly bemused. The goalkeeper grabbed his feet and pulled him down. He's been fairly quiet tonight, was involved in one fairly nasty incident where he appeared accidentally, it has to be said, to have stamped on a Tahiti player's leg. It's not the greatest of tackles. And the ball continues to be at the wrong end as far as Tahiti are concerned, and this could be curtains for them now, and is. Jean-Chris Wajoka has scored a second goal for New Caledonia in the 87th minute, and that has effectively put New Caledonia into the gold medal match at these Pacific Games, where they would take on New Zealand. The result that really puts them out of reach, because they're on 12 points, and they are not going to lose to Tuvalu in their last match. So New Caledonia are on their way into the final. Xiao is missing tonight, red carded in the previous game. Here's Wajoka, who scored the second goal. And there's a third. Just to ram it home for New Caledonia. Nice finish from the number 10. Cesar Zulup has had a pretty good game for New Caledonia. He's been one of their standouts. And with barely a minute to go, New Caledonia have absolutely sealed things now.
Leeds Since 1963, netball is one of the foundation sports of the Pacific Games.
Pressure building there from the Samoans. Chance here for them from Emily Reeves, looking for support. Goes back to Michelle Dowling. Dowling over the head. And they've lost that possession already. A turnover here for Samoa. Good pressure on defense from them. Into the circle they go, Samoa. It's pretty quick. Anasenio, the first point for Team Samoa. There's a loud cheer as well here.
Here in this 16th iteration in Samoa, 8 teams will compete for the coveted medal in the Pacific Games Championship.
Talapi, one of the surviving members from the 2015 Pacific Games team. She's already impressed us early in this first quarter.
Matches began on Monday 15, the start of the second week.
There's so much to be learned from the Big Nations, of course, in netball. And as we've seen early in this day one of competition, the three big teams that are off to a flying start here. It's PNG, of course, the host nation, Samoa and Tonga.
After a series of round-robin matches, semi-finalists will be determined with the gold medal match taking place on Friday, the penultimate day of competition in the 16th Pacific Games Samoa.
So they're racing then in the men's 3,000 metres steeplechase. And I would say, Bob, that obviously it doesn't look like anybody who wants to go tearing into the workload at the moment. It looks like they're just settling down. And Sapalayal, the old stager, leading them out for the moment. There's Levy, the Samoan, sitting in second place as well. 284 is also there at the moment. That's the Tahitian. And Solomon Islanders, Fernie there as well, Bob. Very slow start.
The Papua New Guineans didn't do any warm-up, and it's their own fault. Their competitors should be very annoyed at them. They had to warm up and then stand at the start for a long time.
And to make matters worse as well, it's beginning to rain again here, and this might set in for a little while, I would suggest, this rain, as the first of the steeples is safely overcome by our competitors here. And the first of the big final races are now underway as the light rain begins to drizzle here at wonderful Apia Park. This is Casper now just beginning to assert himself. Simbai Casper had a fantastic run as the PNG team went up through Asia recently. Brought some prize money home as well for the PNG team when they teamed up in a big relay event up there as well, Bob. I think they brought home about $15,000 or something. Now beginning to let the 2017 Vanuatu Mini Games champ know that he's the boss here at the moment. It's PNG in first place. Here he is. Simbai Casper with a qualifying time of 9:32.99, leading over Charlie at the moment from Vanuatu in second place. He's in second place ahead of the other PNG runners now. Looks like Gorese is consolidating as he just dumps into the water jump there. Where Sapalayao fourth, nicely over it. Here comes our leader, sounding like he's getting very close to really controlling this at the moment. Our leader then, the defending champ from 2017, is here. Charlie, incidentally, the Vanuatu runner, went up to Hong Kong the following year, as he's now being passed on the back straight. Sapalai Yao getting very close to getting past the Vanuatu runner. He's just done that. He's going to lap the Samoan as well. Here's our leader. This is a great run here by the favorite. He's done extremely well, Simbai Casper. There's all the action down the back straight with Sapalai Yao has gone past the Vanuatu runner. So the defending champ is in a little bit of strife. There's our leader. Samoan has been passed now. Patelli now just running around and just basically popping over the hurdles. Sapalai Yao beginning to up his pace as well here, Bob, in second place.
Yes.
Down this, and Goresse as well beginning to make a move. He's going to move past the defending champ. Here he comes now near the start finish. There's Sapalai Yao. There's our leader. Goresse just down near the start line has gone past Vanuatu. That's our leader, Sapalai Yao, around near the start of the 800s, has gone over the hurdle. Our leader here just looking like he's getting a little tired. He's made all the running himself. How's this going to set him up for the rest of the games, Bob?
It'll be okay. He's got incredible strength. He'll recover.
Here he comes. Been a fantastic season for him. Just beginning to kick a little bit as well here. This is a great PNG runner here. And he's over the line. A wonderful win. The first gold medal of the 2019 Pacific Games here on the track goes to this man. PNG celebrating.
From and Sapalai in Papua New Guinea.
Here he is, the little guy, the 37-year-old machine, has run himself into second place. What a finish for Sapalai Yao, Bob. This is so elegant that this guy should be able to do this after all these years.
Fantastic.
Look at the smile on his face, and Goresse as well. So it's an emphatic finish for Papua New Guinea in the first medal decided the 2019 Games. Further down the field, the Polynesians are finishing off. There's the Tahitian, Chotau finishing. That's Fiani as well. Still circulating way out down the back straight is our Samoan. But there's the 1-2-3 that Papua New Guinea. And there's a confirmation of our results then. It's a PNG 1-2-3. And as we said at the start of the race, it could have been oh so different. They weren't there when the starter called them up. They turned up late and then they ran 1-2-3 without a warm-up. Here we are at the first round of men's javelin about to get underway. And some big throws expected with a bit of a tailwind here as well.
Oh, that one's close to the edge.
In fact, it might just about be outside the vector.
No, just
is it touching the vector, so it's okay.
Yes.
That's the PNG.
He must be one of the favorites.
That's Gurega. So that's Gurega's first throw here.
He handled the conditions fairly well.
He really did. He really put his shoulder and body into that one. That's a pretty good throw by Gurega. So the PNG fans up and about behind us. Team Samoa getting ready to welcome a couple of their athletes.
Another good throw.
There's Fapoi from Samoa there.
The bronze medalist representing Papua New Guinea, Logona Gurega. The silver medalist representing Samoa, Lawrence Fa'apoi Tasi. And your gold medalist and the Pacific Games champion, representing Wallis and Futuna, Felice Vahai Sosaya. Thank you.
They're racing in the women's 5,000 metres, the first gold medal to be decided in the track and field for women here. And already it looks like Solomon's beginning to make a little bit of a move. Strategy here, Bob, would be from the champ. Is she going to try and race them off her heels? Is she going to sit and kick?
I think that she'll just grind them into, grind them into the track.
So here she is then. Maybe it's already started because she leads quite comfortably at the moment. Well, already it looks like maybe there's a bit of a strategy going on with the PNG squad. I wonder whether they have somebody that's going to try and go out and try and contain Firasu if she makes a little bit of a move soon, or whether they will sit back and just wait. Firasu here, the champ, running the long way home. She's two out at the moment. Probably doesn't bother her. Now you can see that there's a little bit of a break, so the young PNG runner just beginning to lose contact. There's Gaha Keba just reminding everybody that she's not gone yet, running the short way home, sticking to that inside line, not doing any more work than she has to, just letting the others go. Gaha Keba just watching there. Now is she beginning to make a little bit of a move? Gaha Keba just beginning to get a little bit more aggressive. Here she goes. She's sick of this. Gaha Keba makes a move. So the US college-based PNG athlete has decided she's had enough of this. She's sat in, and now she's going to start asserting herself. Now it becomes a time for Firasu here to make sure that she can maybe cover something in second place. Here she is, Mary Tenge. Qualified with a 19.13, with Gaha Keba this far clear of the race, Bob, wondering whether there could be a little bit of a threat on the record. She's got about 200 metres to go. We're clicking over 17.42 at the moment. If she pushes over this last 200, we might have a bit of a record to think about. She's really going to have to motor. Gaha Keba has been absolutely sensational in this, Bob. What do you reckon? Record time or record time?
She's not going to get a Papua New Guinea national record, but as a personal best time by a huge margin.
Well, a championship time by Sharon Firasu is an 8:20.09. She's getting close to it, but I think she's going to be quiet just outside of it. Gaha Keba, what a brilliant run by her. Part of this PNG machine, this running machine that extends all over the world, spent a lot of time up in USA, and here she is for an emphatic win in the women's 3000. Huge win for her. This is a great win by the PNG team. They've got the first two places in the women's 5000 meters. Question is, will young Mary or Monica Kalua be able to hold on to third, Bob?
There goes Mary. So
here comes out second place getter Mary Tenge, and then way back, and it looks like Firasu, the champ, has kicked away clear. She has.
Yes.
So pride here on the line by the great champ. She's going to get a bronze medal tonight. This inspiring runner from Solomon Islands, not being able to produce what she did in Vanuatu or Papua New Guinea. It's a bronze medal for her tonight. It's Papua New Guinea 1, Papua New Guinea 2, Solomon's 3 here in the women's 5,000 meters. It's not a record time, but I tell you what, it's an emphatic win by a winner, Poro Gaha Keba, tonight in the women's 5.
The bronze medalist representing Solomon Islands, Dina Matikali. The silver medalist representing Papua New Guinea, Mary Tenge. And the gold medalist and the Pacific Games champion representing Papua New Guinea, Poro Michelin Kahe Kabe.
This will be the final two events of the night, Bob, as we see out the men's 400s this evening. One more heat after this, and that'll see the decathlon done for day number one. And tomorrow, of course, all comes down gold medal rounds. So they're racing then 400 meters, and it looks way out in front there. That's Tofila doing very nicely, really put in a big first 200, trying to stay with him on the inside. That's Lucian Talvale. This boy is running very, very well at the moment, going to try and hold his form down the back straight. Looks like they're trying to work their way up towards him at the moment. Mosse beginning to try and use the staggers now as they come up to the final 200. This is a brave run by the Samoan. Tofila really putting it out there, but now he starts paying the consequences because of the inside. This is the French Polynesian. Pourier beginning to lift, but Samoa won't be beaten here tonight, not in front of this crowd. He rises again. Tofila coming home. Beautiful run by him. Put it out there. He gets it. Pourier on the inside. And Mossy there as well, trying to stay in touch. But what a brave 400, Bob. And what a run it was there by, well, they've abbreviated his surname. We know him as Tofilau, the 17-year-old Samoan. He just smoked it. He just hit the hammer early. Heat number two, 400. About to get underway, and once again looks like they're going out hard. That's Eager really pushing through the first 150. He's smashing it down the back lane at the moment. Geoffroy trying to stay in touch. He too beginning to respond. You can see that the Samoans beginning to make a little bit of a move. I think Fanua might be tying up a little bit badly on the inside. Maybe he's making a move. Maybe he's going to try and stay with him. Geoffroy here, the Caledonian, trying to run down Eager. Eager had the point advantage. There's the Samoan on the inside. That's Fanua trying to stay. Eager's taken a leaf out of Tofilau's run in the first heat. He smacked it to him. Geoffroy trying to get in touch. Can't do it. Home for Papua New Guinea. Geoffroy is in second place. Back to the Solomon Islander. He's in third. That's Tetonga. So once again, Bob, the boys putting it out there. Ooh. Look at that. A 50.04 for Kao Ego there, Bob. Well, look at that then at the end of the first day of track and field competition. It is Papua New Guinea emphatically getting its competition underway. Two track events and two gold medals, Bob. Wallace Fortuna, of course, traditionally very powerful in field events, and likewise Tonga as well getting in there. Been a wonderful day here at Apia Park for day one. Got a little bit wet at one stage, but the sun came out. So too did the medals. There's a lot more to be decided tomorrow. Great to have your company. Please join us when we get underway bright and early tomorrow in fabulous Samoa.
The holiday feeling that starts in the air. Then you emerge from the clouds to a place where your time is your own, where you have the freedom to be happy-go-lucky or pamper yourself in the lap of luxury, where you can dive into adventure, nourish your body and feed your soul. A place where you can plan every step or take it as it comes. This is your Samoan holiday, and it's always gonna be beautiful. Beautiful Samoa.